Hi to all. In this video, we are going to see about load test on three-phase induction machine. Why it is called induction machine or induction motor? Okay, just like a transformer, it works purely based on induction principle. We are not going to give any supply to the rotor. We are giving supply only to the stator. Based on the induction of stator and rotor, the motor starts to rotate. Okay, let's see load test on three-phase induction motor. Okay, so to conduct load test on three-phase induction motor and plot the following characteristics: BHP, brake horsepower versus slip; second one, BHP versus efficiency; and third one, BHP versus power factor; the finally, torque versus speed. These are things we are going to find using this experiment. And here we are using the voltmeter, ammeter, wattmeter and tachometer. Voltmeter 0 to 3 is 600 volt. MI. Oh, why you are going for MI? It's a AC. Okay. For the DC we are using MC instruments. For the AC we are using MI instruments. Same way ammeter also MI, 0 to 10 amps. Okay. Wattmeter 10 amps, 600 volt. And tachometer, which is used to measure the speed of the three-phase induction machine. And this is a circuit diagram for the load test on three-phase induction machine. Here we are connected two wattmeter W1 and W2. For the W1 we connected between R and Y. Similarly for the W2 we connected between B and Y. Okay, the Y is common for R as well as B. Okay, and the brake drum is mechanically coupled to the three-phase induction motor, and spring S1 and S2 are connected with the belt, and T1 and T2. Okay, when we increase that tension in the T1 and T2, that brake drum belt will be tightened, the load will be applied. Corresponding values of voltage of this one and ammeter's readings we should take. Okay. This is a procedure. Connections are made as shown in the figure. Okay, measure and note down the circumference of brake drum by using cotton thread. Spring balance S1 and S2 are kept in zero out position by operating the adjustment wheel T1 and T2. By keeping the three-phase transformer voltage in zero output position, the supply switch is closed. Vary the outer transformer voltage gradually and apply the rated voltage around 400 volt. The no load readings of all the meters, ammeter, voltmeter and wattmeter, are noted down. The induction motor is loaded gradually by tightening the belt till the rated current. At each load, all the meter readings and speed are noted down. To stop the motor, the load is removed, belt is loosened and the three-phase auto transformer voltage is reduced to minimum position and supply S1 is opened. Let's see the experiment demo.
The equipment what we are using, one is auto transformer and another is DOL starter, direct online starter, and voltmeter, one, two ammeters, this one and this one, A1 and A2, and two wattmeters, W1 and W2. Now I tell how we should use the connections. Here it's a three phase, so we have RYB. Okay, the ROB connection we are given to the auto transformer, that is three phase auto transformer, input of RYB. Then from that auto transformer we take the output of RYB, then the voltmeter we are going to use for measure the supply voltage. So the voltmeter will be connected parallel between two voltages, that is RY or RB. Okay. Then this ammeter is connected series with the R coil, and the other end of the R coil is connected to wattmeter 1. Okay, so wattmeter another end goes to R. Okay, second thing, here one more wattmeter side W2 will be connected to B. It is B phase. There are three phases. In that B phase, we have connected wattmeter 2 through the ammeter A2. And DOL starter And auto transformer, we can connect directly to the device starter. Why we are going to give the connections to the auto transformer means to give more protection for the experimenter. Okay, suppose if any short circuit occurs, in the case of transformers, three phase transformers, we can increase the voltage gradually. So the equipments what we connected to the circuit will not be affected. But if you connect DOL, direct online circuit, that time if any short circuit occurs, it will be damage the equipments. For the purpose, we are using auto transformer in this. TPTT. First, we should switch on the MCB. After that, DOL starter, we must switch on. Okay. Then, we should increase the voltage in auto transformer. See here, the voltage value will increase. Corresponding, the motor starts rotating. We have to check the speed of the motor, that it should come up to 1500. Again, we should increase the voltage. One four two. Yeah, 1470. Now we got 1000. Again. Little bit. Is it? Yeah, we got 1490. Okay. Then once it reaches the rated speed of the induction motor, now you note down the no load values of wattmeter 1, wattmeter 2, ammeter 1, ammeter 2, and the voltage. Now we should increase the load by adding the load here. Okay. Once you increase the value of load, the current, corresponding current of ammeter 1 and ammeter 2 will increase. Okay. For different loads, you should take the values of wattmeter and ammeter and voltmeter readings. Okay. Then, once we complete that one, we should release the load value. That auto transformer gives that value. So it's 0%. One, then switch off the DOL starter, then MCB.
Yeah. Once we completed that experiment, we must fill that table of column V1. A, W1, S1, S2 and difference of S1, S2, N, speed, torque, brake horsepower, output in watts and slip and percentage efficiency. Do the calculations using these formulas, and this is a model graph of brake horsepower versus efficiency, speed and torque, and torque versus speed. So corresponding that graphs, what we got now, for that values we should draw the graphs for this experiment, and results, hence the following characteristics curves are obtained: the percentage efficiency versus brake horsepower, speed versus torque, and brake horsepower versus torque. And these are the some of the important questions which we'll ask for the viva. And thank you. Ime?